video, we're going to see about difference between OLTP and OLAP system. Both are different time kinds of system, where both meant for different purposes. Let us try to understand these systems in detail in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to learn the concepts in data warehouse and press the bell icon for notification. Let us begin with the definition. The OLTP stands for Online Transaction Processing, that used to capture, store, and process the data for transactions in real time. So basically, this is meant for your online transaction processing, like use it to capture your data, meant for capturing your data. That system is built for your transactions to happen quickly. Whereas OLAP systems is like online analytical processing, uses complex queries to analyze aggregated historical data from OLTP system. Basically, this is meant for read, like it has to read from the complex aggregated historical data, right? It is used to build the aggregated historical data, and it should be optimized for reading that. If you're still not convinced what is this, let us go to our architecture. Now, whatever you see here, the data sources, and if it is from the database or any applications, mostly this will be the OLTP system. The OLTP system is nothing but assuming you have a banking application or online application. So those systems is meant for capturing the data very quickly. We will go for a banking scenario. Like you go to a bank and you do some transactions, right? You transfer some amount, or you are crediting some amount, or you want to do closure of loans. Everything is data capturing system. Whatever operations you request for, it is one record in the database. So this system, the OLTP system, should be optimized for your operational processing. That is what it is. And assume you are an online retailer, and you are running a retail garment shop in the online. And for that, you built one application. That application stores the data in database, and whoever purchases, right, those information also to be stored here. So this system is meant for insert should be optimized. Capturing should be optimized. Now let us read the definition. The online transaction processing captures, stores, and processes data from transactions. So each operation or each purchase, your transaction, when you go to a banking, you apply for some credit or debit of amount, that is one transaction. So this is meant for transaction processing. That is why it is called online transaction processing. Whereas OLAP system, where the OLAP system is, so here it is. So basically, the OLAP system, the data warehouse plays a major role, because you build a star schema or a snowflake schema here. From that, you build a multi-dimensional model called OLAP systems. So when you ask me whether tabular model is an OLAP concept, yes, the concept behind that is the same, because all the data is pre-aggregated. You design the model and the data stores here, but exactly not the same as multidimensional model. But OLAP is meant for reporting, because all your data are pre-aggregated and stored here, and only the query fires from any reporting layer, not only Power BI, it can be Excel or any other reporting tool. So the answer will be very quick. So this system is meant for responding the queries quickly. This is not designed for accepting the request for insert, right? Storing the data. I mean, even it stores the data. It is not designed for capturing the data very quickly. It is designed for answering the data for the queries. That is the thing you need to understand. Now we go back to the definition of OLAP. It uses a complex queries to analyze and aggregate historical data from OLTP system. So forget about that OLTP system, it is a little confusing. Meaning like the OLAP system gets the data from OLTP system. That is what it meant. Let us try to see how the OLTP data stores. So this is how OLTP data will store, like a tables, like you have a transaction items sold. This is a typical OLTP system, how the data will be stored. Whereas the OLAP system stores the data in a form of cubes, multidimensional. So assume this particular cell, what it indicates is like, this particular cell is nothing but from accessories in 2015 Jan, this is one of the measure, it can be a sales. So this particular cell represents accessories 2015 sales. When it comes to this particular cell, it is 2015 April and it can be a clothing, or this measure can be a sales. So it is nothing but we know in our data model, like when the transaction or sales happens, the following are the different dimensions: product, time, and it can be a location. So these are different dimensions, and anyway the people is going to ask from this combination, this particular time, this particular product in this location, how much sold. So these kind of different combinations are combined or computed based on different aggregation of measures and stored, right? Each cell represent different combinations and the value stored. So when the query fired, so it immediately navigate to the cell and give you the answer. No need to compute at that time. This is the logic behind cubes or OLAP. This is the why the OLAP is super performant than your OLTP system in terms of queries. Let us quickly compare the OLTP and OLAP systems. So what is the main function? It is for day-to-day operations, and the OLAP system is for decision support. Database design, application oriented. This is subject oriented, meaning like you have a finance, and for finance team you will design one OLAP cube with respect to finance or human resource, like a data maths, right? But when it comes to database OLTP system, based on the application requirement you will design that, right? And data is current, up-to-date data, whereas OLAP system stores historical, summarized, multidimensional mode. Usage is repetitive, and this is ad hoc queries. Access, when it is used, meant for write and read, right? Here lot of scans, right? So even if we cannot say read, we are saying it as scans, lot of scans to this OLAP. Unit of work, it's simple transaction, and you can have a complex queries. Data size is gigabytes, here it is terabytes. Transaction throughput and query throughput responses. So these are the common difference between these two. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.